Welcome to the Jamie Grant Christmas Special! Starring Jamie Grant as Juan Cholo, Murray Vebers as a Wookiee, and Callum Garden as Callum Garden.
Hey, Murray, could you close the space window, please? I'm getting a bit of a draft.
Yeah, sure.
Thank you.
Yo, guys, I think we lost him.
Oh, thank God.
Okay, that's some good news.
Exactly.
Wait, I'm picking something up.
Magnifier?
Okay, I'll try.
I got a bad feeling about this.
Right, there you go. I got it. Huh? What is this?
Punch it! Punch it! Get us the hell out of here! I suppose we should probably say, welcome to the Christmas special. Yeah, this is the Christmas episode.
In January.
Yeah, I know, we're a bit late. Just...
I mean, speaking of Christmas special, where's your sweater?
I'm not wearing a fucking
motherfucker,
Christmas
why you not wearing that?
I'm not wearing a Christmas
sweater. I swear to God,
park this dumbass shit. That's Christmas spirit at 100% now. And you know what, guys? I think you're right. I think you've shown me the meaning of Christmas. So, you know,
it's no bad.
Yeah, I got you guys a Christmas present, you know? Any questions?
Nope.
We're watching the Star Wars Christmas special.
So now that we're safe, we can get on the review. Scene 1 has Chewbacca and Han Solo escaping the Imperial fleet to try and get Chewbacca home to his family for a life day.
This is a Christmas special.
Life day is a knockoff version of a Wookiee Christmas.
So is it a death day?
I mean, I'd hope so.
We call it the 4th of July.
I mean, that's fair. That's very fair. And then we cut to Chewbacca's family. Chewbacca's wife, Mala, his son, Lumpy, and his dad, Itchy.
To be fair, I'm glad you remembered their names.
Yeah. I'm sorry, I've watched the damn thing twice. I decided, no, we're watching this sometimes, so I kind of have to watch it now.
We've got comment about how weird Itchy looks.
Itchy's like part way eating his face. Like a full time.
Yeah, 100%.
He's eating his nose, he's licking his lips, he's doing madder.
He's got chapped lips for sure. 100%. 100%.
Lumpy's a creepy little crunk.
I've never heard of crunk before. Who roll it?
Who
doing it live. We're doing it live.
Lumpy.
Fuck it.
Lumpy has no upper lip.
Does the do you?
Have the shots with Lumpy. His teeth are so prominent, and half the time he looks like he's masturbating. Every close up on him, it's like.
Who the actor was, but they had to put loads of work into like
I swear
putting emotion into his eyes, because that's the only part you could see.
Lumpy is utterly mortifying. His eyes stare directly into your soul, and his teeth are the main thing on his face.
He's like sitting there doing like, he's like moving his eyes all the time.
Yeah.
He's like scanning the room.
Not to mention that he's a fat little shit.
Alright.
That's his name.
Right, and then we get generic mom. Mom.
Can we just say that none of this is subtitled? Like, the entire movie, apart from the actual humans, they're just making noises.
Yeah, the entire thing is moans and grunts from Wookiees.
You start losing your mind.
And with the occasional Wookiee translator being the shopkeeper.
Like, to be fair, I can see what they're going for, because Chewbacca is in the subtitle, isn't
that? Nah. Yeah.
But like, he gets away with it because the folk ruined him.
Mm. And that, yeah. With Chewbacca, and in the movies he's normally in, the situation around him allows you to kind of guess what he's going for, even before the actors then go, great idea, Chewbacca, let's go into hyperdrive. Yeah. You know, like, they build it around him, and this is just, right, do something, we'll work with it.
And we have to literally guess what they're saying, unless the one character who speaks Wookiee explicitly says it to us.
Yeah.
So, which, to be fair, Han does most of the time.
Yeah, but Han has to do it with a character we care about.
Yeah.
These are just
family.
Just his family.
His family who end up,
who apparently everyone in the universe just knows.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
Forget this is set straight after A New Hope. And the entire Rebel Alliance has only just met Chewbacca and Han Solo, but now Luke knows his family perfectly, Leia knows his family perfectly.
Why is C-3PO with Leia?
Why are they doing taxes?
I thought him and R2-D2 were supposed to be boys.
I mean, technically they're both owned by Luke, so why are they separate?
Yeah, I thought they were supposed to be boys, unless they're on any kind that they're related.
Wait, what?
Well, no, he only finds that out, like, in the third movie or something.
Yeah, it's Revenge of the Sith, and they find out when...
Did he be trying
Revenge
to
of the Sith?
Yeah.
Get the broomstick!
That's done.
Yeah?
Yep.
Punished?
Yeah, don't want to talk about it.
Yeah. Well, sorry, wrong trilogy. Also, sorry about the fucking scene.
Yeah.
I do not have a hip of steel.
Took it like a trooper.
Right, where did we leave off before we started arguing? Right, so the Wookiees and the stuff. They're living their daily life, and Chewbacca isn't home yet.
So they start to worry, don't they?
Absolutely.
They start to worry. So, they end up giving a friend a call, because apparently everyone knows Chewbacca's family apart from the Empire.
And now they pick up.
What?
And everybody always picks up their phone.
Yeah. I'd like to live in that reality.
Because nobody's busy ever.
Exactly. So
except
Luke,
everyone's busy constantly.
Luke picks it up. And honestly, sounds like a serial killer. He's so weirdly condescending.
He is.
He fucking hates R2.
Oh yeah, he's a bully.
He hates him so much.
Constant bullying.
He just bullies.
R2's meant to check on the ship part thing.
So R2 then warns him about that ship part.
Oh look!
And then look up.
R2, no. R2, no, I'm busy.
R2, why didn't you warn me? It's now busted!
Then R2 decides to be a G on the third attempt. R2 fucks up the part. R2, what'd you do that for? Come on.
And then he hangs up, and the Wookiees are in the exact same place as they were, and we're forced to listen to the exact same things as we were. Great stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Honestly, brilliant time. I'm just going to turn the front light on in the ship.
God. It's getting dark.
It is.
So like space is always dark.
I mean, yeah, we're just...
A deck of
space!
Space, the final frontier. Space, the final frontier. Oh wait, wrong franchise.
It's dark. It's stuff.
The lights are off.
The light are off. The light is off.
But no, it's weird. Like, no, it wasn't that memorable. As weird as it is.
No.
You'd think such a disastrous thing would be.
I'll just
like Harrison Ford. He just completely rejects its existence. He pretends he was never part of it.
I can't blame him.
Yeah.
Even, like, in it, he looks like he wanted to be part of it. To be fair.
He goes through it like a trooper.
You get a sense, like, for a lot of them, that that's, like, the case.
Yeah. They were under contract.
Yeah.
That's the kind of deal.
And it's...
Like, Harrison felt bad that he took a percentage of what the movie made, so he's like, I'll do this.
Fuck it.
More money, and then he doesn't make any money for it because it's straight to TV and then disappeared a month later.
So then she phoned, then they phoned Leia, right?
Yeah.
Or is this
was it the traitor or Leia?
No, I think it's a traitor.
Right, it's a traitor.
The really awkward traitor and the Imperial officer.
Yeah.
Who's off duty but acts like he's on duty.
Yeah, it's just.
They talk about a grooming device that apparently just does everything else, so I'm like, why even need a kitchen?
Yeah, people don't talk like that. That's essentially what we're getting at.
People don't talk like what they talk like in this movie. I mean, Wookiees might.
But we don't understand
what they say, so...
We don't know what they say. It's fine. We can just say, yeah, they talk like that 24/7.
Oh, Christ.
Can I just say Lumpy's a little shit?
He's a little greeting.
PG Gallop?
I mean...
He's a little grunt.
He's just big boned.
He's just big boned. It's just far.
All I'm saying, he gets asked to do dishes or whatever the week equivalent is. I actually understood that.
It looks like a suburban home. I think it's just dishes.
Yeah. And he just, from what I gathered, no, I don't want to. Mumping and moaning at his mother. And then she turns around, yeah, no, you're doing the dishes. And then he did,
God awful cooking scene. That god, if we're on the subject of the kitchen, we're talking about that cooking scene. She had like four.
Sir, what?
And just occasional, at the very, very end of the whole sequence, bang! But, see, cooking is fun. Now, after showing you it once, let's do it together, but faster.
But faster.
It just kept happening.
Honestly,
it overstayed its welcome.
And then
this movie overstayed its welcome.
The cartoon was kind of sick, but I was jumping.
They hit a 20-minute cartoon in an hour and a half long movie.
I mean, to be fair, the cartoon.
And all the muddles, like all the I say the muddles, but like all like the. All the characters looked off. Like, Han got it the worst, though.
Squished faced, let's go, publisher. Publisher editing. Eyes closed with the occasional right eye opening.
God.
Excellent.
It looks like he didn't make it out of the trash compactor in time, to be honest.
Oh, Christ.
What was good? What was good?
The cantina scene, I think. Probably it.
I mean, bye, friend. Don't say why.
That had like some rapey undertones, though.
What do you mean undertones?
For the guy that like drinks.
Volcano head was very creepy.
He was very.
It
like,
wasn't. It wasn't undertones. It was
overtones.
Literally.
Like.
It was the main bit. Yeah, the whole like 10-minute segment dedicated to him.
Because he just been like a creepy stalker. Because. he basically did what most creepy stalkers do and take what you normally say to everyone else as you're just being you know, special for them.
Mm. Yeah, he was convinced that she was hitting on him last time he was in the bar. And then took it the complete wrong way.
And then, you know, Empire put down a curfew and everyone had to go home. And
Empire is shutting us down!
And then she goes around the bar trying to kick everyone out, and then the only thing that gets them to leave is her breaking in song. Which, to be fair, is probably the best song in the whole thing.
That kind of the band was alright.
Like, the band is always alright.
But they were...
And then they remixed it in the Fred song.
They just slowed it, dude. They didn't remix. They just slowed it, dude.
I mean, yeah, you're not wrong there, to be fair.
We could probably spend the time to find that out.
Yeah.
But we're not going to, because this movie doesn't deserve it.
No, it's an hour and a half.
We're doing a Christmas special.
Not a...
After Christmas.
After Christmas.
It's not a remix discovery. It's just... a review.
Yeah.
As a review of something that doesn't really deserve it.
So the Empire enters the Wookiee's home. Okay, I'll just say, that's the best, you know, accuracy with a blaster I've ever seen in my life. The way they hold it. It's incredible. I've never seen a man hold a gun by the ammo clip before. Do they even reload their guns?
No.
That's what you
yeah.
We were watching it, me and Calum got into this conversation. And it's like...
It's Battlefront 2.
Battlefront 2.
Battlefront 2, shotgun, he's an assault. Simple as that.
He's an assault class packing a shotgun.
Exactly.
He got force pushed up the mouth. That's the only way I can explain it.
So, they leave this... the Imperial General leaves this stormtrooper behind, saying, look, watch the door for them, that kind of thing. So, of course, what he does instead is he goes upstairs and just obliterate this kid's little translator device that he built. And then we had to sit and watch 10 minutes of a full-blown tutorial on how to build this fake, not-real item, in-universe item. So we just watched him smash it for no reason after he was told to not even go up there. And then, he gets in a fight with Han Solo and Chewbacca.
Bear in mind, said room was already ravaged by...
The same guy!
He's going up, holding his gun like he normally does, goes up to the shelves, and just tears apart the shelves for no reason. Meanwhile, the officer is ripping apart the kid's favorite teddy bear for literally no reason.
Strips off his head. He could have cocaine down there. You don't know.
But legit, like he blocks it. Wastes everything.
So eventually Han Solo comes and Chewbacca walks in all badass like, and then immediately just gives up.
Yeah.
And just stands with this kid with a blaster point.
And then Captain
masterful tactics, walks up, knocks his gun out of his hand, and then just a little, whoa, and then the clumsiest stormtrooper in the world just falls off of this 900 foot, 1,000 foot tall tree
fucking
house.
Fell through a balcony.
Bear in mind, the fences of said balcony had to be super weak.
Yeah, but the kid at the start of the movie is walking on it.
Yeah, I mean, strategy for the kid.
And then,
strategy.
Like, their way of getting away, like, around this stormtrooper
kid
death is the traitor calls up the Empire and is like, yeah, he robbed us blind and he ran for the hills. They don't even bother checking. They're like, alright, we're going to send some people after him.
We believe you.
We believe you, people we just suspected of having rebel scum in your house.
I mean,
all right.
Yeah, sure.
We believe you.
No one can land on this planet because we're searching it. Because Darth Vader's like, I'm going to search every house in the galaxy for Han Solo and Chewbacca.
Which they found
that
really
way.
Easy.
They found that house insanely cool.
They found Dave.
They found like the first house they went to.
And then they found him on the ship trying to get to Caesar's.
I mean, honestly, if my husband was a rebel, maybe I wouldn't let my family live on the planet that his species is most known for. I mean, it's just an idea, you know. He's a Wookiee. Maybe you don't live on the Wookiee planet. Plus, maybe you just live somewhere else.
Plus, Kashyyyk is one of the most imperial planets in the galaxy.
I know. Maybe you just, I don't know, move to the Outer Rim until the whole Empire thing dies.
I mean, it will only take a couple of years, but it's not too long in the long run.
Yeah.
Considering you're a Wookiee.
Not too long in the long run.
Precisely.
Christ. And then, oh my god,
what?
Harry Fisher, God rest her soul, sings Life Day as all the Wookiees carry their fucking magic balls through space into this light.
You all carry Wookiees for the magic
balls. And Han Solo, who just said he has to go now, is instantly back. Like I was gonna leave you, friend.
I mean, the real question is...
You go up to the ship and realize you left these keys.
Fuck, I'm gonna go. Came back and had to take part in the holiday he doesn't care about. Yeah,
the real question is, how the hell did Luke, Leia, R2, and 3PO get there in literal seconds? Meanwhile, it takes Han and Chewie the whole movie to get to Kashyyyk.
Life Day.
It was a life day miracle. It was a life day miracle.
Life day miracle. Celebrate life day this next year. 2020. Life day 2023. Life day 2021. Life day 2019. Life day 100 years, 100 days, every day, life day.
Turns out life day is on
the phone. That's a wild good slogan. I'm just starting to do that.
Fuck.
What? No, it was a mess.
What a shit show.
A fucking abysmal movie.
There was just like throwing things at you. Like, oh, this is Star Wars.
I mean,
you know Star Wars, right? We got Star Wars! We got the blasters! We got the Wookiees! This is Star Wars!
And then at the very, very end, there's chucking clips from New Hope.
It's just all the clips from the New Hope! What made me think is George, because it's only clips from A New Hope, and like, I think it made me think George Lucas wanted to do two more of these after the next two movies and just have clips from that movie. It's just like, sum up the story so far.
Don't even. I swear to God, they don't deserve it.
Oh, it was bad.
I mean,
Star Wars Christmas special, Life Day.
Life of.
Is this the thumbnail?
See you next month.
My mama calls, see you on TV. Since that shit done changed, ever since we was on, I dreamed it all. Ever since I was young, that said I won't be nothing.